And welcome, everyone, to this year's fourth edition of News West 9 Game Time, our second of two shows tonight. And, of course, we're the only station who has two shows on Friday night. Glad you're here with us. I'm Trevor Tankersley.
And I'm Lee Small. We hope you're ready for some entertainment because we've got all your highlight scores and football action from around the Permian Basin tonight. So let's start this thing off the right way, Trevor.
Like we always do.
Game of the week.
This is the Academy Sports Game of the Week.
Well, this week's Game of the Week features two teams coming off of big wins last week as the Monahans Lobos, who are coming off a thrashing of Midland Christian at home last week, traveled to Memorial Stadium to take on a team who destroyed 4A Plainview last week, the Big Spring Steers. Two teams that love to run the football going at it in this one, and Monahans would start out with the ball and pound the rock. Micah Ramsey with a long run down the sideline, but a Lobos missed field goal would leave them with no points on this drive as he's taken down in the red zone. Steers, though, made some key mistakes in this one. Monahans able to block the punt later in the first quarter. That would lead to this after they recover. Let's say recover inside the 10 here. Pedro Cano, he had four rushing touchdowns 1 week ago. One more right there. PAT no good. 6-0 Lobos at that point. Another mistake by the Steers would come here. This time it's quarterback Devontae Anderson who fumbles the snap. Tito Armendariz with the recovery. And the Lobos would make them pay after a couple of plays. They're just inches away from the goal line. Cano finds the opening right here for the score. That would put him up 13-0 after the PAT. The Steers would score with 1:43 left in the first. Anderson, with the keeper himself, takes it in for the score, and it's a one-score game. But Monahans would pull away tonight. They go on to get the win. Final score there, 33-12.
Moving to 5A now, where the Rebels from Amarillo saw firsthand just how good Bradley Marquez was. In their meeting last week, Marquez took over in the fourth, finishing with 376 yards and 6 touchdowns. But there was no rest for the weary, as Permian's D'Anthony Fay and Greg George were on the slate for tonight. Remember, no Tommy Morris tonight after he was suspended indefinitely by Coach Gaines after being involved in an alleged burglary on Sunday. Middle of the first quarter, Permian already up a touchdown. First play following a Tascosa punt. D'Anthony Fay taking the handoff and taking it all the way in for 6. Second quarter, Permian driving once again. Mojo quarterback Landry Serrano can't find it, so he runs it in for the first down himself. Next play, Serrano going deep to receiver Talon Smith. Nice rollout
here. Helps when your quarterback can run.
Across the body, finding him open there. Nice play inside the 10. Then Serrano finding Austin Reynolds in the end zone, putting the Panthers up 21-0. They hold on in this one. Final score, 24-13 Permian.
Staying in the 5A ranks, Midland looking to go 4-0 to start the season as they hosted former district foe Lubbock Monterey. There is Tyler Middleton, and here is Tyler Middleton. Breaks a tackle here and takes it up the left side, and he is gone. Makes one little move back to the inside, and I'm surprised I stayed on him the whole time. He outruns everyone on the sideline. Touchdown, Midland, 7-0 after the extra point. Monterey trying to answer on third down. Quarterback rolls out to the right, hits his receiver for the nice pass play. That would set up a first and goal. They couldn't convert. So here is the field goal. That would make it 7-3.
Love field goals,
Midland. Midland answers right back, though. Who do they go to? That's right, Tyler Middleton again. And the defense doesn't even get a hand. How do you not cover this guy up the middle for the score? That made it 14-3, and Midland runs away with it tonight. Final score there, 62-17.
I tell you what, Trevor, this district has some incredible running backs.
Absolutely,
going forward. As for Lee, though, their offense has been rolling along very nicely as well through three games. They're averaging over 35 points per contest, but that number would be tested tonight against an Amarillo team that was only giving up 9 points per game. Coach Morton looking to push the Rebels to 4-0 on the season. First quarter, Amarillo high, hands off to Ashton Tillman. He's going to take it to the house. Long TD run has the Sandies up 7-0.
Nice,
a couple cuts back. Lee trying to answer as Adrian Horton finds Corey McPherson for the long gain, setting up first and goal from the 1. Nice job here, though. Drag down inside
just
the red
inside
zone.
There.
Later now, Horton fumbles the snap. We saw it in Big Spring's game. Happened here to Lee. Amarillo's Trey Alvarado recovers.
Snap. Important part of the game.
And the Sandies make them pay. Gabe Rodriguez going to take the handoff and take it to the house, making it 14-0. More cutbacks for your pleasure as he takes it in for the score. Two plays later, Horton, though, would fumble again. Another snap, and Alvarado recovers again as the Rebels pull off the comeback tonight, though. They move to 4-0. Good job by Lee there. with a 28-21 win.
Moving to another local 5A on the road, the Odessa Broncos looking to go 3-1 as they travel to San Angelo Central tonight. OHS surprisingly trailing 14-0 already in the first, but Bradley Marquez, I think you've heard of him.
Yeah.
Besides taking it in his hands, he would take that up the left side for the long game here. That would set up this. The touchdown run for Marquez, his seventh in the last two games. Of course, he had six last week and nearly 400 yards. They missed the extra point, and that would make it 14-6. Now it's 21-6. Odessa trailing. They would have the ball back when Marquez does what Marquez does best. Take it to the house. How do you not tackle this guy? How do you put nine in the box with him? Second touchdown of the night. Central would lead 21-13 at the half, but at last check, Odessa was leading us 40-28, and I'm pretty sure that's the final score. We apologize. We're having some trouble right now with the CGs, but we do believe Odessa wins this one tonight.
Lovington Wildcats won the Class 3A New Mexico State title last year. They're also ranked number one in their state this year in the class, and they're already up 7-0 here. Andrews' Tyler Gilbreth throws the interception here. That would set up another scoring play for Lovington. They get the touchdown pass right here, making this game 12-0. Nice pass there. They would go for two and convert the two-point conversion, making it 14-0 already. Andrews trying to answer.
That's an interesting view.
Yeah, that's what the Bugs are seeing on the field. But the interception, Bug, there we go, bites again. Another pick for Lovington, and the Mustangs played well tonight, but they fall in the end, 63-39.
And we're not even close to being done tonight. Much more on the way, Lee.
That's right, Trevor. We've got more highlights and scores on the way right now, just after this timeout.